We want to find the average rate of change of f of x equals 1 divided by the quantity x plus 2 on the closed interval from 3 to 3 plus h. Notice in this example, we have a variable here as part of the interval. To find the average rate of change, we need to find the change in output and divide by the change in input, where the change in the output is the difference of the function values, and the change in the input is the difference of the x values. So we first need to evaluate the function at 3 and 3 plus h. So f of 3 is going to be equal to 1 divided by the quantity 3 plus 2, which is equal to 1/5. So when the input is 3, the output is 1/5. And if we wanted to, we could write this as an ordered pair, where the x coordinate would be 3 and the y coordinate would be 1/5. Now we need to find f of 3 plus h. So we'll have 1 divided by, we're substituting 3 plus h for x, so we'll have 3 plus h plus 2. We can combine the 3 and the 2, so we'd have 1 over 5 plus h. So when the input is 3 plus h, the output is 1 divided by the quantity 5 plus h. Which again, if we wish, we can write as an ordered pair, where the input is 3 plus h, and the output would be 1 divided by the quantity 5 plus h. And now we have the information we need to find the average rate of change. To determine the change in the output, we'll determine the difference of the function values, or as ordered pairs, the y values. So we'll have 1 divided by 5 plus h minus 1/5. And then for the change in input, or change in x values, we'll have the quantity 3 plus h minus 3. Now this is going to be a little more challenging to simplify than the previous examples. We need to find a common denominator when we have a denominator of 5 and a denominator of 5 plus h, which means this denominator needs a factor of 5, so we're going to multiply this by 5 over 5. And this fraction needs a factor of 5 plus h, so we're going to multiply by 5 plus h over 5 plus h. So now we have a common denominator of 5 times 5 plus h. And the numerator is going to be 5. Then we'll have minus 5 minus h. Now let's look at our denominator here. We have 3 plus h minus 3. The 3 simplify out, so we just have h. And of course, 5 minus 5 is equal to 0, so we have negative h all over 5 times the quantity 5 plus h divided by h. Let's go ahead and write this as a multiplication problem. We have negative h all over 5 times 5 plus h divided by h over 1, which is the same as multiplying by 1 over h. Notice in this form, the h's simplify out, leaving us with a negative fraction. We have negative 1 divided by 5 times the quantity 5 plus h. So this formula here would be the average rate of change for the function on this given interval, which means when h is greater than 0, we could use this formula here to determine the average rate of change on the interval.